Welcome everyone to another edition of Talk of the Town. My name is Mo.
And I am Tom.
And it's great to be back.
No, I gotta yes.
Yes, it is.
It's always great to be back. Yeah.
It's great to be back. Love the pink.
Yeah, you think? Yeah. Is it pulling it off?
Takes a real man to wear pink. I'm just saying.
Hey.
Yeah, I'm liking it.
I thought I'd take some chances today.
Yeah, well, it looks really, really nice. So things are good? You've been
yes,
well?
Real good. Just wrapping up adult rec league soccer. I've been getting back into soccer
know
this
that.
Year. Yeah.
Okay.
It's been a lot of fun.
Wow.
Yeah.
It sounds less dangerous than hockey.
Hockey. Yeah, I heard your husband. What happened to your husband?
Yes,
he's hurt.
He took a little spill, and he's going to have rotator cuff surgery.
Yeesh.
I know. Yeah.
Ouch.
So, not good.
Ouch.
No, not good. There's a reason why you should retire, I think, from sports, but whatever. Yeah. So anyway, oh, and I have to tell you, you know, I work at KDWA AM 1460,
yeah.
And my boss at the radio station, Dan Massman, said that any time now we could take him out of this Talk of the Town show, because it seems like he's in every episode kind of as a joke. So,
oh,
yeah.
This, you mean, just so we're clear, this Dan Massman? That we're seeing right now?
Dan Massman from AM 1460 KDWA, the owner,
the
operator.
Owner of 1460
mm-hmm.
AM
General
radio.
Manager, the
this
one who
guy.
Signs my KDWA checks. Yeah.
Who dresses so well.
Yeah, that
and poses
guy.
So well in pictures. We will leave him alone. Dan, we will leave you alone.
Okay, good. Well, that's good. I'm glad
we can leave him alone.
If we cleared that up.
For a little bit.
And the other thing, too, is somebody said to me, that watches the show.
Yes. So we do have somebody.
Why
That's
are
good.
You laughing so much during the whole show? And I said, I don't know. It's just so funny. So this time I think I'm going to lay off the cough syrup. So I'm going to see how this show goes.
Oh.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, I've noticed, you haven't coughed at all.
No. I'm laying off the cough syrup.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, so hopefully I'll
working.
Do more.
It's working.
Should we talk about our best friendship
yes,
and how it's
I was going to say, you know,
Please
we ran into each other.
Please let me access my 4C iPhone, which I've been told is very outdated.
Yeah, you're way like, but it's like 99, isn't it? Something like that.
But it works for me. Okay, please hold.
But yeah, we ran into each other at the fire department open house.
What do you mean? Didn't we plan to be there?
No.
I'm doing some scrolling. Oh, we didn't? Here's a cute little selfie of us.
Oh, look at that.
Yes, we were having fun.
Talk of the Town.
Yes. Oh, and then this is weird. I could have done without seeing that. Yeah. It looks like you have adenoids. You might want to look into having those repaired.
Adenoids. I don't even know what adenoids are.
Don't we all have them? Maybe yours need to come out. I don't
Whatever.
Know.
I think I'm going to talk to my doctor before I take your advice on that.
Do you think
that.
So?
Yeah,
okay.
I think I'll do that.
So what else?
Well, what is going on? Let's see. Well, I've got some headlines for you.
You know, that's my favorite part of this show. I can't wait to hear.
Always got some headlines
Excellent.
For you, Mom. Here are the top headlines, the news you cannot lose, no matter how hard you try. We start with good news for you bridge crossers. Those driving across the new bridge this winter will not have to worry about ice. MnDOT announced the new anti-icing system will be ready to go this month. It was supposed to be ready last winter, but they hit a snag called winter.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But the anti-icing system will be ready this time, and MnDOT wants drivers to be aware and feel extra safe when crossing the bridge. So they went so far as rolling out a catchy radio ad using a popular song.
Mo. I love it.
Yeah, take a listen.
No ice, ice, baby. No ice, ice, baby.
All right, stop. Brought to you by the Minnesota Department of Transportation. All right.
That is catchy.
Yeah, it is.
I hope that's going to be on KDWA.
I think it will be.
Okay,
Dan's going to be all over that, I would think.
Dan Massman?
Yeah, Dan Massman, this guy. Photogenic guy right here that we're showing. Now, stop me if you've heard this story.
Okay.
Hastings Walmart has announced it will increase stop sign enforcement in its parking lot.
Oh.
Apparently, now you get that first line.
I do. I haven't heard that, so I won't stop you.
Apparently, more and more drivers are ignoring the stop signs, the hundreds and hundreds of stop signs. And if it continues, Walmart has threatened to add even more stop signs. So that story may not stop there. Huh? Huh?
I don't understand how to drive in.
I think I've been hanging
lots.
Around with Take a Hike Mike a little bit too long here. The Hastings Fire Department is about to hit a growth spurt. Tom Murray will stay right where he's at. I'm talking about a staff growth spurt.
Oh.
12 more firefighters will be hired by the department to meet the increase in need. They now have around 3,200 calls a year, Mo.
Wow.
Do you know that many? As compared to just 750 back in 1977. They say one major requirement of the job will be to answer the phone. 3,200 is a lot of calls.
Right.
And I think Tom Murray was in on this one. They must grow a mustache, too.
Oh, yeah. That's great. Mm-hmm.
So I'm totally in. I just got to give me a few years and I'll get in there.
Me
they
too.
They probably can't wait that long.
Me too.
You in there?
Yeah.
All right. Finally, the 2015 anti-drug and violence calendars are now available. The Dakota County Attorney's Office, that county, not the .. county, office holds an annual contest where over 1,000 kids send in drawings with an anti-drug and violence theme. Are you familiar with that?
No, I wasn't, but I'm for it.
You're for it?
Yeah.
Well, good. Because otherwise, if you weren't, you'd be pro-drugs, I guess, huh? Pro-violence.
And violence.
You don't want to be that.
Neither of those
no.
things. No.
So we're very pro this calendar.
Yeah.
And just 12 kids got picked for the calendar. Here are a couple that made it. Very nice. Look nice. But then we also, a couple of my staff members on HCTV, they like to draw.
Yes.
So they asked if they could submit their own work. And I was, why not? So we got one from Mr. Ross Brockman here. HGTV is my drug. Very
That's
nice.
Very cute. That's
Although
very
he kind of looks like he's wearing a straight jacket.
Yeah.
Kind of straight jacket look, but hey.
What happens
still good.
Here stays
we get,
here.
We get the message. It's a good message. Uh-huh. All right. And then Tanner Bainey drew this one.
Don't watch. What's that other part?
I think it's don't smoke.
Okay. Don't smoke.
Watch JTP.
JTP.
Yeah. Just the plays. He does a lot
just
of sports.
The plays.
It's a program
I get
he does.
It.
Yes.
I get it. That one, we'll have to maybe put subtitles underneath.
Maybe. I think it might need a little help. No offense to Tanner on that one. And then, even our own Take a Hike Mike took a shot at this.
Take a Hike Drugs.
Take a Hike Drugs.
Love it. Now that's, why didn't that one make it?
And I think it's a pretty accurate self-portrait, though. I mean,
it is.
He's got the blonde hair.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think it looks pretty good. Well, that's the Tot headlines for this time around. And we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're in for a thrilling time, I understand, right?
I like how you say that. Yes. Cue the music. Welcome back, everybody. Now, Tom, I am very excited because people get to see a little something at the senior center.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
See some dance moves, some thrilling action. That's for sure.
That's right. I got to use my ARP card. It was all good. So we're gonna find out what the talk of the town is. We are here with the instructor who did such a great job, Monica Moen. You had a group to work with. Wow.
Oh, yes, I did. They're a blast. It was a wonderful combination of lifeguards, which is special needs, and then we had the seniors, and then we just had normal people who enjoy Halloween.
Is that Tom?
Yes.
Tom.
Yes. I actually had a wedding couple that for their bachelor and bachelorette party, they wanted to do Thriller, so I came up with a Thriller routine for them, and then the community ads started to pick it up, and I've been doing Thriller, about 5 years.
What is the talk of the town?
Halloween and Thriller.
Tell us, what do you think of this class?
Oh, I think it's a fabulous class. Gets us all out, connecting to other people in the community, and gives us a little exercise.
I understand, you're part rooster. You got some rooster in you. Tell me about that.
Yep. Well, see, I get up early in the morning and go out to a doctor out in Maplewood and have him do some shots with rooster comb in my knees.
Rooster comb? I didn't know rooster had combs. What part of the rooster is the rooster comb?
Well, it's got this big piece that's up here that just kind of dangles on the side and sometimes stands up.
How does it feel to be part rooster?
Makes me want to crow a lot more.
The Walking Dead here at Tilden.
I got to tell you, the 80s, you know, I love the 80s. This brings me back.
You look like a natural out there, Mo.
Yeah, well, speaking of natural, some guy just asked me if this was a wig. No, it's not. I actually have a rooster comb underneath here, too.
I think it's a great look. I think it's a great new look.
And I like your look as well. Yeah, this is kind of what you look like when you just roll out of bed in the morning.
Nice. I think I'm going to go with this one, too. This will be known as the tot style right here, folks. Shanika, what'd you think?
I like it.
You like Michael Jackson? Are you a big fan?
Yes, I do. I watch all the video on the movies.
Let's see a move right now. Can you show us a move?
He does this.
Like that. Great moves. Let me see if I can try that. Wow. Huh? What do you think of this Thriller class?
Oh, I thought it was great fun. It was just really neat to mix it up with all ages, playing the classic Thriller. Gosh, what a workout it was. And people were laughing. All we needed was a little bit of fog to roll in. It would be just awesome.
What is the talk of the town, Zena?
Oh, the talk of the town is always community ed. Come on.
What is the talk of the town here in Hastings?
Well, you know, the senior center, we're just trying to get more people involved right now. And so we're looking at what are we working towards the future? How can we meet the needs of people now 50 and over? We've changed our age group down. So,
did you get a chance to see some of my Thriller dance moves in there?
Well, I noticed that you were going backwards when everybody else was going forwards.
Oh, no. I was, but see, they were all wrong. I was right.
Oh, okay.
And welcome back. Mo, I didn't know you could do several cartwheels in a row like that.
You know what? This would explain a lot about the 80s for me, my dance moves from the 80s.
But pretty good.
Boy, I loved that. That was great fun.
Still sharp.
That
still
was
sharp.
Very fun. And I want to say we also are going to talk about something fun coming up, a tradition in Hastings called Gobble Gait. We want to welcome our guests today. Welcome to Jay Kochendorfer and Mary. I always want to call you Hoffman, Mary Fasbender. they are the founders. Did you know that?
I did know that, yes. So thank you for coming in.
Thanks
You're
for
welcome.
Having us.
Now, Jay, it looks like you actually ran here.
I did.
Yeah.
I am preparing for Gobblegate.
Hardcore. That is hardcore.
Yes.
That is hardcore. Gobblegate has been around for how many years?
We are celebrating our 17th annual Gobblegate this year. It's
wow.
Amazing to think that 17 years have flown by.
And how did it all start? What's the story on that?
At that time, Jay and I were both single.
Uh-huh.
Why'd you do this?
Because that was 17 years ago.
That was a long time ago. And we all know that I got married at a very late age. Anyway, Jay and I, and there was probably 9 of us, with us, and we did the Turkey Trot. At that time, the Rip Rap restaurant was open, and a core of those guys, and we went up to Minneapolis, and we did it. And we're like, oh, that was fun, you know. And they had the food going to the Harvest Food Shelter and blah, 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 and it was fun, you know. And we drove around for literally like an hour.
More than that. Maybe a couple.
Maybe, yeah. Well, an hour. Looking for a place to have some pilgrimage spirits.
Uh-huh. Pilgrimage spirits.
You know.
What does that mean?
Cocktails.
Yeah. Bloody Mary.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go.
Nowhere in Minneapolis was open.
No, I was thinking they were going to drink corn.
Well, yeah.
Maize, as we call it.
Yeah. Anyway, there was nowhere in Minneapolis, so we decided to go to St. Paul, and we ended up at Jimmy's. Anyway, we sat there, and Jay and I were actually, I remember like it was yesterday, we were sitting at the end of the bar. And the rest were kind of gathered around here, and we just started chatting. We're like, we could do that in Hastings, yeah, blah, 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 blah. I'm like, yeah. Well, then we really didn't talk about it. And then I think in, it was June, and I called them and I said, okay, if we're going to do this, we better get going. And it.
So you were the one driving the bus. That's so shocking.
Well, I'm the oldest.
So shocking.
And female. No. But that, you know, and I have to say that it all literally fell in place.
How is it shaking up for this year?
We're amazed.
It's huge.
We are amazed every year.
Yeah.
How the community comes together, how the businesses come together, and...
But you also have a lot of people from out of town, is that correct?
We do.
That run the race,
oh,
or
sure.
Make it a family tradition.
Oh, yeah.
We've mm-hmm. heard people say, oh, we used to do the turkey trot. This is so much better.
I love it. Well, we want to say thank you for what you do. It's a great, great event. Really nice way for people to kick off Thanksgiving with their families. A nice tradition that you've started and a legacy that will continue.
It will indeed.
Yeah. Yes.
Very, very yeah. nice. But we are not done asking you questions.
Oh, no. No.
No.
We have some more up our sleeve. So let's go ahead and do our thing with the lights. And yes, they're there. Just trust me. You're about to head into the Tot 5. Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We're going to dig a little deeper with you guys.
All right.
Yes. Starting with you, Jay. You, as I don't know if we mentioned it, you're a DJ. You do
yes.
DJ work off to the side, and you're known for that. And as a DJ, I'm sure you've taken a lot of requests. If you could erase, though, any song from existence that you never had to hear it again, because I'm sure you've heard a few, get a lot of requests, what would that song be that you could erase and never have to hear again?
Oh, that's a great
one. Freebird.
What?
Yes.
Okay, it's so weird that you said that.
Yes.
Because
or Celebration.
Yeah, that's I mean, my favorite.
Like, it just...
Freebird, where did that... Did you...
I just, you know, it's...
Tom Murray's been speaking to us.
Yeah, that was Tom Murray's favorite song, wasn't it?
Yeah, I remember that.
I hear it.
I have a list of cliche songs that I could probably do without.
Well, let's hear them. Come on, rattle them off.
Yeah, rattle them off.
Celebration, cool. Hokey Pokey, The Limbo. Well, maybe not The Limbo. Depends on the type of an event. Hokey Pokey, the...
Chicken Dance?
Definitely the Chicken Dance. Yeah. I mean, it's funny when couples are planning their weddings and they're always saying, you know, please don't play the Chicken Dance. Please don't do this. Please don't do anything.
How about Thriller? Where do you stand with Thriller?
No, I like Thriller. Okay. I like Michael Jackson.
All right.
I love Michael Jackson, in fact.
Mary, I have a question for you. Why are you looking so pained? What is your favorite holiday food for Thanksgiving? It's not a trick question. Is it?
peanut butter?
No. What? Peanut butter. Wow. All right.
It's pretty tradition at our house.
We are getting some questions.
I do. Well, along with that, I'll answer that. I have always had my family for Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. We used to do it on Thanksgiving, which was
too much.
So I've moved it to a couple weeks before. And so I have a very large family, 42 people. My favorite is peanut butter on
turkey,
homemade buns. That's my dessert.
Jay, you also do work as a hypnotist.
Yes, and Mo is hypnotized.
Yes, she is.
That would explain
it explains
a lot. Explains a lot of the behavior here today on TV.
General.
If you could hypnotize anybody in the world, who would it be?
Boy, I wasn't prepped for these questions.
Of course not.
Oprah Winfrey.
Oprah.
Told you.
Oh, Miss Mary, I have another question for you. Did you know that Ben Franklin once wanted the turkey to be our national bird? Mm. Did you know that? Yeah. Okay, so that's my preface question. Of course, it's not. It's the eagle. But if you could have any bird be the national bird, what would you like?
Cardinal.
Oh.
Of course there would.
That's an awesome bird.
Brings lots of peace to me.
Oh, good. All right, and the final one, this is to both of you. This is a little rhyme challenge. Name off three words or phrases that rhyme with Gobble Gait. Go.
Tate. What do you mean now? What?
Rhyme with Gobble
Gait. Gobble Gait. Fast, quick.
Oh, I'm not good at this stuff.
Well.
Three.
There's The scandal with President Nixon.
Watergate.
Toothpaste.
Colgate.
Very good.
Thanks for the help.
I'm trying. You know, I'm just, I love it.
Love it.
Okay. Cool. Was that painful? That was painless.
Yeah, it was painless.
All right. So now.
Well, thank you for making it through the top five. Congratulations for doing that. For anybody.
That was sure rapid fire.
Wasn't it?
We got to give them a plug on how they sign up for Gobble Gait, right?
Yes, of course. All right. Where can people find information to sign up and where to be and all that?
They would go to gobblegait.com. They can get registered right there, and they can start registering as early as right now.
There you go.
All the business sponsors are online. It's going to be a great race. And
well, we want to say thank you. Our guests today, Jay Kochendorfer.
Yes, thank you.
And Mary Fasbender, Gobble Gait. What a wonderful treasure.
Thanks for having us.
Thanks for coming.
And bring your families out and make it a part of your tradition. And
it's going to be a
warm
day
again.
Excellent. It's all good.
There you go. Well, get your gobble on, gobblegait.com. And we're going to take a quick break, come back, and we're going to get our crock pot on here real soon.
Oh.
Looking forward to it.
Everyone, to my favorite part of the show.
Yes.
What a crock. I'm so excited because today, you know, it is autumn.
Yes.
And so I thought we would do something rather autumnal.
Autumnal. I like that.
Now, perhaps, Tom, you will get invited to a little party.
Yeah.
Or you might, you just might want to do something special for fun. And so this is not a meal, just so
not
you're clear. This is just a little dip, and it's called pumpkin.
I'm a big dip fan. Big dip fan.
It's good to know. It's called pumpkin pie dip, made
pumpkin
in a crock
pie.
Pot. Yeah.
Nice.
So here's my crock pot.
And I noticed, yeah, we got a different crock pot here. You
well,
downsized.
This is my little dipper.
Little dipper.
My little dip. It's my little, cute. Yeah, it's my, they even come smaller than this. Do you know that? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They do.
So this is my little crock pot. So would you be so kind? Now here's what we're going to do. This, eventually, we're going to use this lovely real pumpkin.
Yes.
But right now, because I don't want to have to mess with it, we're going to take a can of pumpkin pie.
All right.
Mix.
I'll do my can opening
can,
thing
okay.
here.
Okay. We're going to take half of that. A thing of four ounces of cream cheese, softened, and we're going to put that in the bottom of our crock pot. And then you can plop that in
plop
over
this
it.
All in. All
oh,
right.
I have bad news. Remember your girlfriend?
Yeah.
She is in a kind of a serious kind of relationship with a spatula.
Oh.
Yeah, so anyway.
Yeah, I thought I felt something was missing
yeah,
here.
Yeah, well, you can do this. Or will you get it on
I
your...
I will get it.
Will you get it on your What a Crock tie that you
tie.
Have going on?
Which, yeah, does nicely with your apron.
Thank you, thank you. Okay, and then we want to add, so again, it was 4 ounces of cream cheese, one of the, one can of pumpkin pie mix,
okay.
Right, and then a quarter cup of, close enough for government work, as my husband says, quarter cup of sour cream. Mm-hmm. There you
mix.
Go. So you plop it all in there together, and then you kind of just let it go for just a second. Oh, and then you know what?
Bam.
In honor of Tom Murray, who enjoys the word cinnamon, we just put a little bit of cinnamon in there. Yeah, that's it. And then plop the cover on. Where's the cover? Oh,
where is the
I
cover?
Have the
Let's
cover.
Get it on. All right.
There you go. Now, in the meantime, what you can do is you can hollow out that real pumpkin gourd there.
All right, we'll do.
Would you be so kind?
I'll do some hollowing.
So, yes, so I cut it earlier because, you know, you and knives, you and many things I'm worried about, but knives in particular. So you can just get rid of all the real pumpkin stuff in there. And then, yeah.
Through the guts, nice.
Yep, that's what you do. And then you can just toss those in the garbage. And then we're going to fast forward. We're going to pretend that this is, you want to be stirring this too probably every 15 minutes. I know, who has there time for that? But I told you it's not a meal, it's a dip. It only takes about an hour. You want to put it on low. Is it on low? Let's look. We'll put this on low. Takes about an hour, stir it up, and I'm telling you, it is going to taste like a pumpkin pie. Okay, let's put this over here.
Nice.
Yes, okay, you can, so thank you for doing that. So here's our ingredients. We're going to get those out of the way.
I am at your service, Mo. I don't know if you knew that, but I am at your service.
Okay, so remember, did you listen? How often do we stir it?
Often.
Yeah, 15 minutes. Every 15 minutes. So we won't do our clocks or our watches. You're good. You don't
even
wear a watch.
I don't even wear a watch, yeah.
So you're worthless for this segment, I must say. So the next thing we're going to do is once that is all gelled together, what's the word? Once it's congealed, once it's...
Cooked?
Once it's cooked, yes. Yeah. So it tastes like pumpkin pie. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this. Mm-hmm. We can line this with foil or something. Nice. And then we will pour our stuff in there. It's not done yet, though, Tom. Remember, it's
gotcha.
A crock
yes,
pot.
Yes, it's a crock pot.
Yeah.
For an hour, right?
Right, but I don't have an hour. Like, you made me wait 6 hours last time. Yeah. No, I don't have that time. So this, we're going to, for an hour, we'll pour this in. And then you serve it with, like, graham crackers or Nilla wafers or ginger snaps. Or if you're really fancy, you could do, like, biscotti.
Mm.
Or biscotti, like you would say.
Biscotti.
Yes, yes. You would do this and
biscotti.
Biscotti. And then you want to jazz it up with some almonds if people or is this these are walnuts actually.
Walnuts, almonds. Just make it go along here.
With pistachios. No, yes. You want to jazz it up with walnuts.
Sunflower seeds.
Actually, pumpkin seeds, jazz it up with something. Your nut of choice.
Nice.
You're not included. Anyway, so doesn't this look lovely? Isn't this a nice little
display.
Autumn? Yeah, a nice little autumn meal. Now, if people feel uncomfortable dipping out of a real pumpkin, then you can leave it in your little dipper. But wouldn't that be fun? And it tastes like pumpkin pie.
Mm, yeah? I love pumpkin pie. So.
Well, there you have it. Yes, nice. That is another segment of What a Crock. And I want to say thank you. This was fun. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Yes, thank you. We'll see you next time.
I hope so. Bye-bye.